Hello, I am reasonably British and...
How dare you!
This thing, this beastly behemoth, this monolith of measurement, this titan of test equipment, this colossus of calibration, is the Tektronix VM700T video measurement set from 1996. This is a tool used to analyze, test and measure analog video signals. This relic of the past millennia is so vast and foreboding in its enormity, you don't dare approach it for fear of getting sucked into it like forgotten jewelry into an MRI machine. You baby step to it slowly, like a cat advancing on a cucumber. And if you dare to power it on, you are instantly given a green monochrome window 28 years into the past. Well, not instantly. Things took a long time to boot up in 1996. And it is a dare, because every time you turn this thing on, it feels like this may be the last time. You watch the entire startup sequence with trepidation. Your sphincter loosens with each passing line of the startup diagnostics, and I'm not exaggerating. I had to boot this thing dozens of times for this video, and I was nervous every time. It is a startup sequence so epic it deserves accompaniment from the London Symphony Orchestra. I want you to experience the entire boot sequence of this thing, because it truly is an experience. Everything from the immensely satisfying ka-chunk of the power button to the fans slowly winding up to an idle equilibrium like a proton pack, to the unnecessarily elaborate but absolutely gorgeous visuals whilst it struggles to gain consciousness. And if you're thinking, what? Do you actually expect people to stick around and watch in silence as a useless antique computer boots up? Well, then you fail to understand that this isn't about you. I don't care about you. I'm not here to satisfy you. Ooh, Mr. Reasonable, can you please do a review on my grandmother's Stutz Bearcat? No, you are denied. I'm not your little content generating...
Little whore.
I'm not your goddamn...
Poor wicked whore.
She's a whore.
Some dead whore.
Hey, she was a whore.
Why do you always talk like a whore?
My mother's a fucking whore.
Whores.
Mama's a whore.
Hoorah.
To fully appreciate how pretty this screen is, let's set some mood lighting. Ah, yes, that's nice. Now sit back and relax. Here I am, telling it to skip the hardware that's not installed. There must be a way to remove these checks from the diagnostics, but I didn't see it. And yes, these are the normal power-up diagnostics. There are more extensive diagnostics available, and there's a quick start mode that skips the startup diagnostics. When I bought this, it was configured to run the startup diagnostics as it is now, and this thing definitely came from a working environment. And, oh, look at that. Even more diagnostics after the first round of diagnostics. Can't be too careful, I suppose. Soon we'll come to my favorite part of the startup sequence, the spinny letters of awesomeness, with clicking relays for extra awesomeness. This 3D animation is simultaneously atrocious and absolutely amazing. It's completely unnecessary. Well, as far as I know, maybe this actually is a test for the animation system. After all, this thing excels at drawing, as you will soon see. And we have arrived. Wasn't that lovely? Well, you are looking at the waveform monitor in line select mode. So we are only seeing field 1, line 17 of each NTSC frame. Now here's where shit gets crazy. You can use the scrolly wheel to move smoothly up and down the waveform, and the labels stick to the start of each line just after the color burst. Not only that, depending on your position, they also stick to the vertical scale or the right side of the screen. This tiny little bit of UI garnish blows my mind. In just about every other waveform monitor I've seen, the line number is static and boring. Putting this much thought into a piece of test equipment that sold new for, how much did these cost new? Both the Google and the AI failed to tell me, so I bought the Tektronix product catalogue from 1996, but that only had the VM700A, so I bought the 98 catalogue, which does have the turbo version and a price list at the back, and oh my, this has depreciated quite a bit. And with these three options, that comes to $33,000, and that's in 1998. If you adjust for inflation, that is at least, and then exchange that to the Queen's, carry the two, not forgetting the import VAT and the Stamp Act, and wait, that can't be right, what the devil? Not only can you scroll smoothly through the waveform, you also can move in any direction and zoom in or out. This also has a vector scope, which is actually the jankiest feature in this whole package. You can even view the incoming video in all its greenness. But the real kippers and bits lies behind the measure button. This is where all the Pip-Boy-esque mid-90s user interface goodness lies, because this isn't sold as a waveform monitor or vector scope. This is a measurement set, and behold, for it measures all of the things. Let us touch briefly on each one. Oh, that's right. Did I mention this is a f***ing touch screen in 1996? This is the first measurement screen, and I have no clue what this does. In fact, I don't know what most of these do. But isn't it just gorgeous? I mean, it's the perfect shade of 80s terminal green. It's the kind of computer terminal that doesn't have automatic updates or backups. It doesn't have JavaScript or Flash. It doesn't have a monthly subscription. It doesn't constantly warn you that this website uses cookies, even though every goddamn website uses cookies. It's the kind of terminal that tells you, sure, maybe the AI has taken over, but maybe the humans shouldn't be in control. Maybe humans are stupid. Maybe Joey Pants was right. Maybe if Joey Pants had gotten his way, there wouldn't have been a need for another Matrix. Maybe the last crusade would have been the last crusade, and maybe Star Wars would have ended in 1983 with Yub Nub. Well, let's go through these screens in ascending order of awesomeness. This one measures bounce. Boring. This is burst frequency error. The burst is this thing, which is what creates the miracle of
color.
You know,
color, the touchstone of reality, the vivid pulsating miracle that gives substance to shadows.
There's also this screen, and this one, which apparently measures chrominance noise both before and after noon. There's chrominance frequency response and non-linearity. This one, which measures dig and dip. This measures something. And this one, which is a good old-fashioned level meter. The level of what, you say? This one measures the horizontal blanking pulse. This one apparently measures short distortions in space-time. And this one, which is called, what do we call this?
We call it Mr. Coffee. care for some? Yes!
Now, we're getting into some real visualization goodness. This one checks the levels of your color bars, I think. That looks very useful. Not sure what this one does, but it's very pretty, and like almost all of the measurements, you can zoom in and out and scroll at your leisure. I have no idea what this does, but it's awesome. Is this a way to fix distortion, or is this an over-engineered protractor? I would look up ICPM, but I think I like the mystery. This one is in my top three. It's crazy. Doesn't it look like it should belong in the console of a fusion power plant or monitoring a warp drive plasma relay? It looks like it's trying to control an uncontrollable force of nature, a reaction that is just one missed safety briefing away from catastrophe. But look, just look at this. Look what happens when I give the signal generator the old Sean Connery. Right? And look at it. Oh, very good. That was such a cool animation. I have no bloody idea why it went all sideways, but I found an immense amount of satisfaction in it. Alas, no, this measures horizontal sync jitter. This one measures frame jitter and is reminiscent of a polygraph or ECG. Very enjoyable. This one measures the noise floor, I think. Very nice, very pretty, and it appears to do it per line, maybe? Can you tell I'm more excited about the aesthetics rather than its usefulness? Now this one requires a small preface. In the early stages of all this analog video madness, I stumbled on a wee little booklet called NTSC Studio Timing by Grass Valley. It is an excellent source of info regarding the NTSC video standard. It contains this diagram which describes the vertical sync, the part above and below each field. A very lovely diagram, I must say. Now,
hold on to your butts.
And look at this. This is just spectacular. This shows the entire vertical sync section of the frame, in this case two frames, and see the little bracket highlighting the selected line? If you scroll off the side of the screen and to the end of the first field, it pops up at the beginning of the next field. Oh, this just makes me so happy. And just in case you thought this is a facsimile, look what happens when I change the test signal and when I cut it off. Completely. Oh, that's just the duck's guts. This one may just be my favorite visualization on this thing, although it might be tied with this. This displays the horizontal sync as well as precise measurements of all the relevant bits and bobs. That flat dippy part is the horizontal blanking pulse, and the squiggly bump is the color burst, which serves as a reference for the color information in the following line. I absolutely love this diagram. Again, you can scroll around and zoom in and out, but the measurements also scale with the waveform, and they do that sticky to the side thing, the same as the labels on the waveform monitor. I know. You're thinking, I remember the mid-90s and this display looks a little mid-80s for something that costs $33,000. What kind of buffoonery is this? Well, my good man or lady, step inside my time machine dirigible and take a trip 10 years into the future, into the world of color. Let me try that again. Why don't you step inside my time machine dirigible and take a trip 10 years into the future, into the world of
color.
Ah, that's much better. Yes, this thing has a VGA output that outputs in color, except when showing the actual video signal, which is odd. But that's okay. Everything else is in color, mostly white and green. And I will admit, I think looking at it this way kind of takes the green monochromatic romance out of it. But this is still charming in a Windows 95 kind of way. I suppose if you're going to spend that much money, you should get your choice of nostalgic theme. Well, I guess that's enough nerding out for now. Was there anything else to talk about? I mean, I didn't even show you the longer diagnostics. I'm actually a little afraid to run them. Oh yeah, my VM700 has the component option, so I have all of these measurements as well. And also, the touchscreen menu system doubles as a file browser. Oh, and you can press the auto button and it has a long screen of checks that run on a loop. Oh, and the help system is pretty damn swanky too. I mean, this seems to have an endless amount of awesomeness, but this video is already too long. Okay, do I recommend this? Nope.
Wait. I like the remastered ending. Remastered ending is better.
So you don't like Yub Nub?
I don't like Yub... No.
You're ending, fucked up.
Yavnov is garbage. Sentimental. It's just a bunch of idiots saying. Sounds like a bunch of fish flapping.
How am I friends with you?
What are you gonna do? I don't like Yavnov.
Yo, so I can't believe you don't like Yavnov. I can't believe we've been associated this long.
That's all I am to you, an associate.
An associate, yeah.
Association.
Fuck. It was more before I heard you didn't like Yub Nub. Fuck, that's cringe.
I like quality music. What can I say?
Yub Nub is quality, man!
No, it's not.
It's quality!
It's fish lips.
What does that mean?
Flapping their gums.
Yo, they're just fucking Ewoks doing their thing, man. They're celebrating.
Gum flappers.
Yo, that probably don't even have gums. What's your name? I can't believe I even associate with anti-yubnubs.
Man, shut up. Why don't you go fucking Ewok and tell me how it feels.
Well, that's a little bit drastic,
so
I think.
I love him so much.
I can't appreciate a culture's music without having to fuck one of them.
That's exactly it.
Confirmed.